My name is Mundati Samuel. I'm a graduate in zoology from University of Eldoret, and I've developed a system called Linda, where you can report anything that needs police intervention in real time, and it's very precise because it has a GIS element in it. The Linda system uses a server which strips off the numbers of the community members who send the message or concerning any intervention that they'd like the police to intervene, and forwards the message to the police. So the police receives all messages from the server's numbers only, and that way it acts as anonymous, because the person who had sent the message, his number is stripped off at the server. This is how Linda system works. The community here sends the message to the server. The server strips off the identity and it relays the message to the receiver, who are the security agents. For example, if my number as a community member is 123 and I want to send a message saying that suspected thugs are staying at plot number 10, block 11, room 6, I will send it to the server whose number is 456. The server receives the message with my number. It removes my number and forwards the message to 789, which is the police number. The police will receive the message and it will have originated from 456, which is the server's number. That way, my identity will have been stripped off and I will feel very secure and very happy that maybe I have reported something that could have been detrimental to my community. Before I came with the Linda system, I did research on other applications in the market that do the same kind of job, and I noted that most of them uses internet, unlike the Linda system, which is SMS based, and it does not require complicated phones. With your Mulika Mwizi on any other kind of phone, you can just send one message which will cost you 1 shilling, and the police will get whatever that you are reporting in real time. Number two, I looked at the factors that make people not to report any form of crimes or bad happenings that do happen in their community. One, I noted the major hindrance was the fear of being known, as in there was no witness protection, and most people fear that if their identity is known, it will bring conflict and it will compromise their life. That made me to come up with Linda, which removes all those hindrances and makes people feel like this is a good system that they can embrace to report anything, be it crime, be it environmental injustices, anything that you like. Before coming up with this system, I did researches on what other applications or system same as the are there in the field which work more or similar like this one, and I came to note that most of them uses internet and you have to have high-end phones. These are smartphones and the like. That made me to think of another way which could be much cheaper and easier for everyone to embrace, and that is when I came up with Linda, which can use any kind of phone because it is SMS based. You don't have to have internet and it's very cheap because you send your message using 1 shilling only, and the message gets to the police in real time and it's very precise. Number two, I thought of why do people stick with exam? Why do people fear to report any incidences that happen within their vicinity? And one major reason that I found was witness protection. They fear that if they are noticed, their identity will be made public. This Linda system, which I started developing in 2016 and did my first trials or runs in 2019, it's very useful in reporting anything that would like police intervention, because the BBI, for example, BBI 1, talks of how Kenyans feel insecure, and in page 27 to 28 it says that Kenyans feel insecure, and it gives very many reasons as to why that happens. And the final BBI that was launched recently, it is still talks of how Kenyans feel insecure, and it states that people are the police and police are the people. The people being the police, their role is to report anything that they feel that is not good in their communities, making it a civic duty, because it is not a mandatory thing. The reason as to why we have not actualized this program is because, one, it's a social innovation and it needs different stakeholders in the government, one being Ministry of Information, ICT, that is the Ministry of ICT. It needs the intervention of the police, it needs the intervention of plans and physical planning, and it's not something that you can do it on your own. I have written to the Ministry of ICT and I'm waiting for their reply so that we can see whether they can buy this idea and partner with the relevant stakeholders and actualize it. If my idea is bought by the relevant partners, for example the ICT Ministry, it will be a game changer, because it will assist the police in recording crime in real time, receiving any information that needs their intervention. It will assist in data analysis, crime mapping using the GIS, and I believe it will make Kenya a very safer place where anybody can report anything in real time without any fear that he or she might be known, which instills their confidence because the system is anonymous. I decided to develop this program because of, one, witness protection, as in it is anonymous, so you don't need to be known if you are reporting anything that would bring conflict maybe between you and your neighbors. Number two, the cost involved in reporting, as in you cut it, there is no going to the police station to report anything, you just report it in the comfort of your table or wherever you might be, and maybe you've seen anything that would like police intervention. Number three is very economical. With only one shilling, you can report anything, because it needs only one SMS. Well, when the police receives the SMS indicating where a crime or anything that needs their intervention is happening, they look at the position using GIS. That is when they come to the computer and they select by the location using attributes. For example, here we are looking at the plot names, and the plot name here equals, you get the unique value, which is the plot numbers for that area. For example, if anything is happening at plot number 14, block 11, you just double click it, you apply, and here it is. You can see it has been highlighted, and then you close. rows. Then you pick the identify tool, and again you click on the plot where the crime may be it's happening, and it brings out the attributes of that plot. You have the x and y coordinates for the centroid, that is the center of that plot, that can be used to navigate using the navigation system to get to that plot. Number two, it has the plot number. So if you don't have the digital system for navigation, you can use hard copy maps and pinpoint at plot number 14, block 11, for example, in Nairobi.